system. Now we are going to see the female reproductive system. Here the female reproductive system, primary sex organ is ovary, and it consists of the secondary sex organs, uterus, fallopian tube, vagina, and the glands that are present in the female reproductive system is Bartholin gland and mammary gland. Bartholin gland is just like the Cowper's gland that we have seen in the male reproductive system. Bartholin gland secretes protein which acts as the lubricants, and mammary glands helps in the production of milk during the lactation phase of the female reproductive system. And coming to the ovaries, which is the primary sex organ, it is an almond shaped structure. And it is a pair of ovaries. There are two ovaries present, and it is present in the pelvic region, which is inside the abdominal cavity. We have to remember that in male reproductive system, it is extra abdominal cavity, because the spermatogenesis require 2 to 3 degrees Celsius of temperature below the body temperature. So it is kept outside the body, that is in extra abdominal cavity. But here in the female reproductive system, this ovary is placed inside the abdominal cavity, and it is suspended by a transparent mesenteries. It is suspended in the abdominal cavity by transparent mesenteries called as mesovarium. So it is suspended by the mesovarium, and ovary produces secondary oocyte, which in turn undergoes meiotic division to form the egg. And coming to the structure of the female reproductive system, here it is the egg which is suspended by the mesovarium in the inside the abdominal cavity. Here it has fallopian tubule. This whole structure is called as fallopian tubule, but the structure that is swollen here, it is called as ampulla. This structure is called as ampulla. The fallopian tubule has two structures, that is ampulla and isthmus. The swollen structure is called as ampulla, while the thin structure is called as isthmus. And this ampulla has a finger-like projection called as infundibula. This structure which opens here near the ovary is called as infundibulum. It is a finger-like structure. This finger-like structure produces a suction which holds the ovary here. So this ovary is connected with the uterine wall by a ligament muscle that is called as ovarian ligament. So the ovary is suspended by mesovarium and the ovarian ligament in the abdominal cavity. Because of mesovarium and ovarian ligament, the ovary is suspended inside the abdominal cavity. Coming to this next structure of the female reproductive system, this muscular structure, this fallopian tubule opens inside a muscular structure called a uterus. This uterus is a muscular structure, and the top of the uterus is called as fundus, and it is a uterine body. Here it is a uterine body, and the uterus consists of three layers, that is perimetrium, myometrium, and the endometrium. Perimetrium is the outer layer, and the myometrium is the muscular middle layer. This myometrium helps in the contraction during the labor process when the parturition takes place, when there is an expelling of the developed embryo. During labor contraction, myometrium helps because it is made up of smooth muscles which helps in the contraction. And endometrium involves in the menstrual cycle, the cyclic changes. Humans are primates, and they are placental mammals, so they undergo cyclic changes during the reproductive phase, and that cyclic changes involves hormone change and duct accessory duct changes, and that cyclic changes is called as menstrual cycle in human because they are primates. In non-primates, it is called as estrous cycle, that we have learned already. Though, so the endometrium undergoes changes during the menstrual cycle. So this three layers of uterus opens out in the narrow tube called cervix. So the cervix have two openings, that is internal os and external os. Os is nothing but orifice. So it is internal orifice and the external orifice. The cervix serves as a tract during the child during the reproduction, where the child comes out, it serves as a duct or tube through which the offspring is expelled out, and this cervix opens in external genitalia, that is vagina. Here in female reproductive system, the external genitalia is the vagina. It is a muscular structure. The inner lining of vagina is rough, and this inner lining is made up of non-keratinized striated epithelium, and this vagina opens out in a opening called vaginal opening, or it is called as vulva. This opening of vagina is called as vaginal opening or vulva, and this vulva is closed with a thin membranous structure called hymen in case of virgin female. In case of virgin female, there is a thin membranous structure which closes the vaginal opening, and that is called as hymen. And this vagina along with the cervix act as the passage for the child to be born, and this offspring will come out of the uterus through cervix and vagina. So cervix and along with the vagina acts as the passage for childbirth. So this is all about the female reproductive system. We will see about the accessory glands present in the female reproductive system. Coming to the internal structure of ovary, before that I have to tell this. The ampulla where the egg is released is the site of fertilization, and from that the zygote that is formed by the fertilization will move on to the uterine wall, and there it gets implanted. So the site of implantation is uterus, and whereas the site of fertilization is the ampulla. Now we move on to the internal structure of the ovary. This is the almond shaped ovary, which consists of the follicular cells. This is the primary follicle, which is formed. This follicular cells are formed every month. Since it is a primate with the cyclic changes, human is a primate with the cyclic changes every month, and it is called as menstrual cycle. Follicular cells are formed every month. So this is a primary follicle that is formed initially, and this group of cells in which only one cell becomes a secondary oocyte. See, only one cell becomes enlarges and becomes the secondary oocyte, that is the ovum. And the secondary oocyte, when formed, it is surrounded by numerous follicular cells and forms the graafian follicle. First primary follicle is formed, later graafian follicle is formed, where the secondary oocyte is surrounded by the follicular cells. And coming to the internal structure of the detailed structure of the graafian follicle, here the center of the graafian follicle is the secondary oocyte, which is the which gives the rise to the ovum. The secondary oocyte is surrounded by a layer of follicular cells, two layers of follicular cell. The layer which is close to the secondary oocyte is called as discus pyogenes. See here, the outer layer of the ovum is called as tunia albuginea, that I forgot to tell you. Here in the secondary oocyte, the first layer which surrounds the secondary oocyte is called as discus pyogenes, and it is surrounded by another layer of follicular cell, that is called as membrana granulosa. This outer layer is called as membrana granulosa, and membrana granulosa is made up of two layers of follicular cells, and the first layer is called as theca externa. This layer is called as theca, and the outer layer is called as theca externa, whereas the inner layer is called as theca interna. So between the secondary oocyte and the outer layer, that is membrana granulosa, there is a cavity that is called as antrum. Antrum is the cavity that is present in between the secondary mucosa and the membrana granulosa, and this cavity is filled with liquor folliculi. It is a viscous liquid which is formed by the follicular cells, so it is called as liquor folliculi. And this secondary oocyte is not swimming on the liquid. It is actually fixed by a mass of cells called germ hill or gemellus oophorus. So it is suspended in the liquor folliculi by a mass of cells called germ hill or gemellus oophorus. So this is the structure of the graafian follicle. This graafian follicle is named after the scientist who discovered it. Hence, it is called as graafian follicle. Graafian follicle ruptures to release the secondary oocyte, and it is called as ovulation. Actually, ovulation is called as the release of egg, but it is not actually release of egg. It is a release of secondary oocyte where the graafian follicle ruptures, and the secondary oocyte which is engulfed in the graafian follicle will get released. And this stages is described here. It occurs in three stages. First, the graafian follicle ruptures and the secondary oocyte comes out. And there is a blood vessel rupture, and it is followed by the clot. And this empty graafian follicle is released here. And that stage is called as corpus hemorrhagium. Hemorrhagium because there is a rupture of blood vessels. So it is called as corpus hemorrhagium, and the second it is a red body actually because of the rupture of blood cell, and the second stage is a yellow body here, and it is an empty graafian follicle, and it is called as corpus luteum. Corpus luteum acts as a temporary endocrine gland, and it produces progesterone. We all know that the first half of the menstrual cycle is dominated by the estrogen hormone, and the second half of the menstrual cycle is dominated by the progesterone hormone. This is because the graafian follicle is ruptured, and it forms the corpus luteum, which acts as the temporary endocrine gland producing progesterone. So this progesterone acts as a dominates the secondary half of the menstrual cycle. After the corpus luteum, in the third stage, this corpus luteum get degenerated. So there is a degenerating corpus luteum and forms the corpus albicans. When this secondary oocyte formed undergoes meiotic division and forms the ovum, if it is not fertilized, then there is a rupture of this ovum, and menstrual cycle is formed. If there is no fertilization takes place during the course of time, then it will rupture and forms a menstrual cycle. So this release of egg approximately happens on the 14th day of the menstrual cycle. So the menstrual cycle longs for 1 to 28 days. At the 14th day, the graafian follicles will rupture and release the secondary oocyte. So this is the structure, internal structure of the ovary. We will study about the hormones and glands related to the female reproductive system.